When you analyze the financial results of a company, operating segment information can be very insightful. This is where financial accounting and management accounting meet, where the external reporting largely aligns with the internal reporting. It's an opportunity for a company to provide transparent, useful information to investors. What a company might call a business unit or division internally is called operating segment or reportable segment in external reporting. Let's go through some real-world examples of segment reporting before we dive into the accounting principles and rules that regulate it. What can we learn from the segment reporting by Amazon, Apple, ExxonMobil, and Verizon? In Amazon segment reporting, three operating segments are disclosed: North America, International, and AWS. This is what I would call a hybrid structure. The first two operating segments, North America and International, are geographically based segments earning money from retail sales of consumer products and subscriptions. The AWS segments earns money from global sales of compute, storage, database, and other service offerings. In revenue, AWS is 12% of the total. In operating income, AWS is 63% of the total. Based on the relative profitability of the operating segments, you could argue that Amazon is primarily a high-margin cloud computing company, doing some low-margin retail on the side. Besides the revenue and operating income numbers, you can find information about segment assets, property and equipment, as well as depreciation and amortization by segment in the Amazon annual report. Apple operates on a geographical basis. The sum of the net sales for the five geographical operating segments adds up to the total net sales for Apple as a whole. On the profitability side, the operating income for the five geographical operating segments adds up to a total number called segment operating income. From this, you deduct research and development expense and other corporate expense to tie out to total operating income for the company. This is a good example of a reconciliation between the total amounts for the reportable segments to the financial statement amounts. From the ExxonMobil discussion of operating segments, we learned something about how to best define the operating segments of the business that are reported separately. The factors used to identify these reportable segments are based on the nature of the operations that are undertaken by each segment. The upstream segment is organized and operates to explore for and produce crude oil and natural gas. The downstream segment is organized and operates to manufacture and sell petroleum products. The chemical segment is organized and operates to manufacture and sell petrochemicals. These segments are broadly understood across the petroleum and petrochemical industries. In other words, this structure of reporting operating segments allows investors to compare divisional performance between competitors in the same industry. If a company reorganizes internally, then the external segment reporting changes accordingly. Verizon 2.0 has two reportable segments that the company operates and manages as strategic business units: consumer and business. Verizon previously operated and managed the business under its historical wireless and wireline segments. For comparison purposes, highlights for both the current and previous operating structures are represented here side by side. These real-world examples of segment reporting illustrate how useful operating segment information can be to investors. Do a search using the terms segment information or information about segments in the notes to the financial statements of the 10K filing of any listed company and see what you can uncover. What are the accounting principles and rules that regulate segment reporting? Under US generally accepted accounting principles, ASC 280 is the place to go. Under international financial reporting standards, IFRS 8. These standards are largely converged. In other words, they treat the topic roughly the same. Both standards are based on a management approach to identifying and measuring the financial performance of an entity's operating segments. Reported segment information will be based on the information used internally by management. What is the definition of an operating segment? According to ASC 280, an operating segment is a component of a public entity, an entity whose equity or debt securities are publicly traded, that has all of the following characteristics. It engages in business activities from which it may recognize revenues and incur expenses. Its operating results are regularly reviewed by the public entity's chief operating decision maker to make decisions about resources to be allocated to the segment and assess its performance. Its discrete financial information is available. That's a definition that accounting experts can hold a week-long conference on, or write implementation roadmaps for, of about 100 pages in length. Let's zoom into two of the main elements of the definition. Chief Operating Decision Maker. That's not a job title you'd normally find on any org chart of a company. The CODM is a function and not necessarily a person. You identify the CODM by determining which individual or group of individuals is responsible for allocating resources to and assessing the performance of the operating segments. This is likely to vary from entity to entity. It may be the CEO, the chief operating officer, the senior management team, or the board of directors. Its discrete financial information is available. Discrete financial information may consist of only limited results of operations information, such as revenues and gross profit margin, without balance sheet information. And for the non-native speakers of English, discrete, D-I-S-C-R-E-T-E, is not the same as discrete, D-I-S-C-R-E-E-T. The former means individually separate and distinct, while the latter means careful and prudent in one's speech or actions, especially in order to keep something confidential or to avoid embarrassment. In segment reporting, there are three quantitative tests that companies perform: the 10% test, the practical limit test of 10, and the 75% test. The 10% test. A public entity shall report separately information about an operating segment that meets any of the following quantitative thresholds. Its reported revenue, including both sales to external customers and intersegment sales or transfers, is 10% or more of the combined revenue, internal and external, of all operating segments. The absolute amount of its reported profit or loss is 10% or more of the greater of either the combined reported profit of all operating segments that did not report a loss, or the combined reported loss of all operating segments that did report a loss. Its assets are 10% or more of the combined assets of all operating segments. Operating segments that do not meet any of the quantitative thresholds may be considered reportable and separately disclosed if management believes that information about the segment would be useful to readers of the financial statements. So there are suggested thresholds for disclosure, but even if an operating segment does not meet any of the quantitative criteria, a company could choose to report it separately. Alternatively, two or more operating segments may be aggregated into one reportable segment if they have similar economic characteristics, as in the range of the entity's business activities and the economic environments in which it operates. If the number of segments rises above 10, the entity should consider whether a practical limit has been reached. This limit is logically connected to the previous test, as 10 segments that each meet the 10% test one way or another will get you to around 100% of the business results. The words "should consider" indicate that this is a soft test, where a company has the choice to differ from the suggested approach. A real hard limit test is a 75% test. A company needs to report additional segments if external revenue of all segments is less than 75% of consolidated revenue. Adding additional segments decreases the all other segments category and needs to get the sum of the reported segments revenue above the 75%. What's the core principle behind operating segment reporting? An entity shall disclose information to enable users of its financial statements to evaluate the nature and financial effects of the business activities in which it engages and the economic environments in which it operates.